Hello students. Okay, today I am going to continue with my same lesson, that is ancient civilizations of the world. So in the last class we have seen about the Egyptian civilization, contributions of the Egypt and the Nile Valley. So today I am going to continue with the same topic, that is about the Nile Valley. So I already said you this Nile Valley, in the rainy season the Nile Valley will turn into the huge river. In summer season it will dry up. It is used for the two purposes. What is for the grazing field and also for the growing the crops. So when the Nile river in the summer season it will dry up, it will leave a fertile layer. So that is very useful for the cultivations of the crop. And that Nile Valley is providing food for the population of the Egyptian civilizations. So let me continue. So in the beginning, graves. So we have already seen. I already said you all that the dead bodies were very systematically with they apply the chemicals and all. Why they apply chemicals and all? So that it shouldn't be spoiled. And they will put in the coffin box. With that, they will keep all the items required for the future and all. And with that, two dolls, that is especially cook and the barber cook. He will cook the food, the baba, he will do shaving beard and all. And the priest is saying that the life is temporary on earth. So we need to prepare the life for the next life. So these are the things. And I already said you that the Nile Valley is also a burial graveyard for them. And in the beginning, the grave were created by carving into the rocks in the hills. So in the first starting, if anyone will dead, means where they used to keep inside the rocks itself. Where they used to keep, the Egyptian civilization people, they used to keep inside the rocks. So normally now what we are seeing, either they will bury them in the ground or else they will burn. Yes, so here they used to keep them inside the rockets. Inside the rocket, all the items are on them and the two dolls. As Egyptians moved north, they had to construct graves in the desert itself. Towers were built on the graves using huge block stones in order to protect the internal sleep of the dead. So that people who are dead. So when they were in the south, they used to keep in the rocks and all. So when they moved to the north and all, their school was in a desert area. So in that desert area, what they did, they couldn't find any rocks and all to keep the dead body. So what they did, they started constructing the graveyards, tall towers and all. So you must have seen, it will be in a triangular shape. They started constructing with the huge blocks. Blocks are nothing but they are called as bricks. So huge, big bricks and all. They started constructing. After constructing, what they used to keep the dead body inside that, applying all the chemicals and all, wrapping with a thin white cloth. And here they used to keep in the coffin box and all. And all the items what are required for them. And with the two dots. So this is the thing. And kings and wealthy people means rich people, vied with each other to build taller and taller towers. Means competition was there itself between the kings and the wealthy people. There is a competition. So I have to build a huge taller tower. I have to build the taller tower. So this kind of a competition was there between the kings and the wealthy people, rich people. And Greeks called these structures pyramids. You all know the pyramids, it will be in a triangular shape. So these are called as a pyramids. Who are called these pyramids? The Greek people used to call them as a pyramids. And the kings of Egypt were called pharaohs. What they called itself? They are called as a pharaohs. After an independent, prosperous life for 20 years, Egypt was ruled over by an Arabian shepherd tribe called Hyksos, which attacked it, and after defeating it ruled for 500 years. And they looted the wealth of the natives, means neighboring villages and all. and hence did not become popular. The Jewish became wandering, wanderers, means they don't have any permanent places. They used to move from one place to another place, to the desert in search of the shelter, were also hated by the people of the Egyptians. So first starting what happened, the hypostyle are called as in a, they are the Arabian shepherd tribes and all. They came to Egypt. So the Egypt. So they came to Egypt to take the not to take the shelter, only to rule over the Egypt itself. So how many years they ruled over Egypt itself? That it was in a 500 years. Only thing what they used to do, they used to loot the wealth of the native places and all, nearby places and all. And like this kind of a destruction, they used to destroy the things and this kind of things they used to do itself, both the hypostyles, the Arabian tribe people. And they didn't become popular. Why they didn't become popular? Because they are not kind-hearted people. So when we are kind-hearted people, then only the people will like you. So when they are like an evil people, only they came to do destruction, to destroy, that's it. So the people started hating them. So 500 years they ruled over the Egyptians. After the hypostyles, you know, who had come, the Jewish people, they who came wandering for the shelter, means they will be moved from one place to another place. The Jewish people also came with some, but the Egyptian people, they did not welcome them. They started hating them because they are called as, you know, foreigners. And by cooperating with the foreign rule, the Jewish even assisted them in collecting tax and in administration is what rule. And in 1700 BC means what, before common era. So the people of Thebes rose in revolt against the foreigners after a prolonged conflict, prolonged war, battle and all. They succeeded in chasing out Hypostyles from their country. Who in 1700 BC, that is 1700 BCE, the Thebes. So they had a fought with the Hypostyles. It was in a prolonged, this one was in a very long conflict. It's a conflict means what? Battle. So at last they could successfully drive out means chase out the Hypostyles from their country. And once again the Egypt became free. Once again after a thousand years. And it came under the rule of Sardana Palas of Assyrian. And the Persian emperor Cambyses occupied Egypt in the 6th century BCE. So that again Alexander occupied Persia in the 4th century BCE. Egypt became a province of the Macedonia. Provinces means what? It's an area, territory of the Macedonia. And one of the Alexander's military general, what he did? He declared himself the king of Egypt and established dynasty of the Ptolemy. He founded the city Alexandria. At last came the Romans, that is in 39 BC. The last Egyptian queen, that is Cleopatra, tried her best to save her country, Egypt, from the hands of the enemy people and all, but she couldn't. It was said that Romans feared of her beauty more than her troops. It's troops means what? Army. So with that we come to know that Cleopatra was a very beautiful lady, and not only beautiful, she was very intelligent also, and her army also very strong. Her troop is nothing but her army also very strong. So all the country people, they used to fear for her beauty. So such a beautiful lady she was, and she even knew 14 languages also. And and twice she was successful in her attack upon the hearts of the Roman conqueror. Twice she attacked the Roman conquerors in capturing the Egypt. Means twice she was successful in protecting the Egypt. So last what happened? And however, in 30 BC, Caesar, successor, he's son-in-law, her mistress, did not tempt by her beauty to her beauty like this, like her father. Means who is this Caesar? Caesar was an husband of the Cleopatra itself. Caesar, he fall in love with the Cleopatra and he married her. But Caesar, what happened? He was murdered in a battle. And after Caesar, the Roman successor was his son-in-law, was an Augustus. So Augustus, he wants to capture the Egypt. He wants to rule over the Egypt. He want to capture and extend his empire. So that was an aim. But he didn't attempt for the beauty of the Cleopatra. So what did Augustus do? He did not attempt like his father-in-law. As his father-in-law, he is an Caesar. And what happened? But defeated her army. Though he spared her life, but he did not kill Cleopatra. He planned to carry her to the Rome, from Egypt to Rome. So what happened? In between, Cleopatra consumed poison and ended her life. From then onwards, Egypt became the provinces of the area of the Roman. So Cleopatra, if you want to tell about the Cleopatra, Cleopatra is a very beautiful lady. So everybody used to fear for her beauty itself. And she was successful in defeating, in protecting her country, that is Egyptian civilization. And but she at last she failed to protect her country from the hands of the Augustus. So what happened? Augustus, he defeated her army people and he wanted to carry her, but he spared her life. But Augustus spared the life of the Cleopatra. He didn't take her, he wanted to take her to the Rome, and maybe he wants to keep her in the prison. But she didn't allow him to do that. She consumed more. Normally, she didn't consume the poison, but she was bited herself with the poisonous snake and killed herself. So after death of the Cleopatra, the went into the hands of the Rome, that is an Augustus, and it became the provinces. Provinces means territory of the Rome. So here it ends about the Nile Valley. So here what we have seen, so starting we have seen that the graves, about the graveyards. So when they came to north, they started constructing the huge towers, and there was a competition between the kings and the wealthy peoples, and all to construct the tall towers and all. And the Greek people, they call this as an pyramids. They used to keep the dead body inside the pyramids. They used to very systematically, they used to apply the chemicals, and they tell that it is an internal life, and all the items required for them, and the two dolls and all. And the first, the high priestess, they ruled over Egypt for 500 years and all, but they didn't become popular. Only why they didn't become popular? They used to loot the wealth of the people and all. And after them, the Jewish people had come. They are the wanderers. But they were hated by the Egyptian people. Slowly, what the Jewish people did, they started doing work in the administration and collecting the taxes and assisting in the administration and all. So these are the things later, the Tibbies. They raised their voice against the foreigners and all. They could successfully drive out the foreigners and all. And the last queen, that is Cleopatra, she married the Caesar, and the Caesar was murdered in a battle. And the Cleopatra, Caesar's son-in-law, that is Augustus, he defeated the Egypt, he defeated the troop army of the Cleopatra's. And when Augustus wanted to carry Cleopatra to Rome to keep in the prison and all, but she consumed poison and she ended her life. From that onwards, the Egypt came into the hands of the clutches of the Rome. So here I end the Egyptian civilization. Next class I'm going to continue with the other civilization.